who will be punished more when they died? A Muslim fanatic religious Gentile or a Gentile that is not religious at all? Two Arabs, Mustafa and Muhammad. Muhammad, fanatic Muslim, fasting 40 days in Ramadan, praying five times a day, does not eat pork, does not charge interest from his brothers, believe in one God, believe in Muhammad, and believe that the Quran is the word of God. And Mustafa, regular Arab, maybe believes in God, but does not practice any Islam, no religion. Who is worse in the eyes of Hashem? Who is going to get the biggest punishment, bigger punishment when they both die? Mustafa or Muhammad? Who is going to be punished more? Muhammad, the religious Muslims, will be punished more. Why? Mustafa will also be punished. Why didn't you look for me? Why didn't you look for your purpose as a goy, as a Gentile? Why didn't you keep the seven laws? Why didn't open the Torah and see what's your purpose? Why you hate the Jews? He has a lot of issues, and he's going to be punished for that. But Muhammad will be punished a lot more for following a fake religion, making up fake rules. For that, he's going to get a bigger punishment. Because if you have to follow a fake religion, you might as well don't follow any religion. Just believe in God better than to follow a fake religion and a fake prophet. And the proof, it's in the Torah. A Gentile that bowed down to a God thinking it's God, like the sun. He bowed down to the sun and prayed, "Dear God, help me, I love you." What's his punishment according to the Torah? Death penalty. His friend, the other Gentile, that doesn't believe in anything, doesn't get killed. No death penalty. But the one who bowed down to the sun, thinking it's God, saying thank you to God, I love you, you're great, I want to be close with you, thinking the sun is God, death penalty. Whether he's a Jew, whether he's a goy. So what do you see? Following a fake God, a God of lie, or a fake prophet, is death penalty. Do not believe in God. You have a serious punishment when you die. I'll take care of you for your stupidity and your chutzpah. But while you're alive, nobody can execute you. Why? You're not an idol worshiper. You understand? All these fanatic Muslims, imagine if they only imagine that for every day they go to the mosque and pray and they don't touch pork and they do all kinds of things because they think this is what God said, they're going to be punished for every day for following a fake religion. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. And that's the truth. A person that decides to fast. Why are you fasting, Muhammad? I want God to have mercy on me. I decide to fast today. No problem. For that, he's going to get a reward. He's not fasting because it's written in the Quran he has to fast today. He decided to fast and to give charity to the poor. He will be rewarded for it. But he fasts now 40 days of the Ramadan. For every day, he will be punished. Because he say and believe that this is what God said. And if you only check carefully in the Quran, in 1 hour you would know that it cannot be the book of God. It's full of mistakes. You make mistakes, you pay for your mistakes. Some of them, maybe it's not their fault. It's their parents' fault. They brainwash them. They think it's the will of God. Yes, I'm not God. He knows how to calculate that. But black on white, dry law, you follow a fake book, for that you have a special punishment. You give power to a fake prophet, death penalty. Whether you're a Jew, whether you're a goy, doesn't matter. Following a fake, same thing Christians. Following JC, 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 Christ, all their nonsense. Every time they mention his name and pray to him and believe in him, special punishment is registered to the file.